Function on the living level and who has magnetic control It is the law of love in the three worlds that holds all together, and that draws all upward. It is the demonstration in the triad of the law of attraction. On the path of involution, this law works for the permanent atoms in the causal body. It is the Buddhic principle, and its relation with the lower permanent atom of the triad is the mainspring of the life of the ego. On. The path of descendant has much to do with the placing of the permanent atoms, but this matter is very abstruse, and the time has not yet come for further elucidation. As the third outpouring, in which the fourth kingdom, the human, was formed, it was this law of magnetic control that effected the juncture of astro-animal man and the descending monad, using the spark of mind as the method of atonement. Again, we can see how it works. The monadic plane, the Buddhic plane, and the astral plane are all three closely allied, and we find here the line of least resistance. Hence the facility with which the mystic contacts Buddhic and even higher planes. The lines of least resistance in the three systems are System I, 2, 3, Physical, Mental, and Atmic. The Atmic was the highest point of achievement in that system. Astral, Buddhic and Monadic. Mental, Atmic and Logoic. Note the correspondence therefore to be seen between the fourth kingdom and the working of this, the fourth law. It is a vital moment in this fourth chain. As regards human evolution, this fourth law is of prime importance at this time. The aim of human end. THOUGHTANDFIRELEMENTALS 585. The is supposed to be controlled by this law, and likewise to wield it in service. It is the law whereby sex expression, as we know it, is transmuted and elevated. Sex is only the physical plane demonstration of the law of attraction. It is the working out of that law in the human kingdom, and in all the lower kingdoms, too. The love of all that breathes, and the attraction that works out in service, is the same thing as demonstrated in the triad. Sex expression, the coming together of two, becomes transmuted into the coming together of many for acts of service, which will give birth to new ideals, and to a new race, the spiritual. Here I might point out a numerical fact that may be of interest in connection with the fourth hierarchy. This human hierarchy is the fourth, as we know, yet if we count the five hierarchies that have passed on, it is in reality the ninth. Nine is the number of initiation, the number of the adept, and of the man who functions in his Buddhic vehicle. The fourth ray also operates in close connection with the fourth law. It is the ray of harmony or beauty, harmony through control, that control entailing the knowledge of wisdom. It is the harmony of similarity, it is the equilibrizing of all through the realization of the laws of magnetism that produce the coordination of the many diverse into the one homogeneous. Magnetism governs the synthesis of the many aspects into a form of unity. This harmony is reached through the fifth plane, and the fifth ray of concrete knowledge acts as a step to the fourth. For many who work on the fifth ray pass eventually to the fourth. In this system, the fifth ray is of paramount importance in the development of all egos. Each must pass some time on it before definitely remaining on his monadic ray. In many incarnations, much time is spent on the fifth subplane by the fourth ray, and in this particular period of the fourth round and the fourth gene, more time is spent on the fourth subplane by evolving egos than on any other. Many come into incarnation directly onto this plane, and it is here that they begin to think harmoniously. The laws and the three worlds. We will now take up and briefly study the three most important laws affecting the evolving human being as he lives his life in the three worlds. These laws are 1. The law of fixation. 2. The law of love. 3. The law of sacrifice and death. These laws are all dominated and controlled eventually by the three higher laws in the system. The laws of magnetic control, of disintegration, and of cohesion. There is a direct connection between these seven laws and the seven rays or vibration, and if we study the correspondence, we shall recognize the fact that the first law, that of vibration, is the controlling law of the sixth, demonstrating through the second law, that of cohesion, just as the solar logos is at this time manifesting himself through the second aspect in this the second solar system. The first ray of the power is the first aspect of the all-self, and in the third outpouring, 83 came. 83 the three outpourings. In the diagram, the symbols of the three aspects of the logos are placed outside of time and space, and only the streams of influence from them descend into our system of planes. They represent in due order what are commonly called the three persons of the Trinity. It will be seen that for each, above an outpouring of life or force is projected into the plane below. The first of these in order is the straight line, which descends from the third aspect. The second is that part of the large oval which lies on our left hand, the stream which descends from the second aspect until it has touched the lowest point in matter, and then rises again up the side on our right hand until it reaches the lower mental level. It will be noted that in both of these, outpouring to divine light becomes darker and more veiled off of the sense. THOUGHTHANDFIRELEMENTALS 587. Down to the fifth plane, along with the other monads. A subtle correspondence exists between the monads of the on the fifth plane, the fifth law, and the fifth ray. Ray of the love wisdom aspect holds control on the fourth and sixth planes, and dominates the laws of cohesion and magnetic control, and the astral law of love. There is a direct interlinking between the abstract rays and the laws of the planes where they specially control. The third ray, which is the activity aspect, controls the laws of disintegration and of death, on the third and seventh planes. Therefore, it will be apparent to the careful student of the wisdom that 1. The power aspect ray 1, planes 1 and 5, and the laws of fixation and vibration, form one interlocking whole. 2. The love aspect ray 2, planes 2, 4, 6, and the laws of cohesion, magnetic control, and of love, form another unit. 3. The activity aspect ray 3, planes 3 and 7, and the laws of disintegration, sacrifice and death, make still another group. It is logical for the first ray only to be controlled, as yet, by the matter through which it passes, but retains its virgin purity and splendor untarnished. It will be noted that this outpouring descends only to the level of the buddhic plane, the fourth plane, and that the link between the two is formed by a triangle and a circle, representing the individual soul of man, the reincarnating ego. Here the triangle is contributed by the third outpouring and the circle by the second. The Christian Creed, by C. W. Leadbeater, pp. 39, 40, 588 on cosmic fire. Goes on three planes. It has the preponderance, for paramount you hear the monads of love, and love is our synthesis. Grade 3, the dominant ray of the system which is cast, its synthetic ray, controls on two planes, and on one that is little understood. Or, just as the physical body is not considered a principle, so there is a sphere of activity that is not included in our enumeration, it is past and gone. Some explanation of this lies hid in the occult words, the eighth sphere. In regard to the four minor rays of harmony, concrete science, devotion and ceremonial order, their control exists in degrees on all the planes, but they have their particular incarnating ego in the three realms of this time. These four rays control, in a subtle and familiar manner, the four kingdoms of nature, mineral, vegetable, animal and human, and at their merging into the three raised aspect, the activity ray of the Mahatmahan being the synthesizer of the lower four in our planetary scheme, have a correspondence with the merging of man, the product divine hermaphroditic man working along. 598 TRE on cosmic fire. The lines of more positive development. The abstract rays do a similar work on the positive human hierarchy, tending towards a more receptive attitude. This hierarchy forms the masculine aspect of the divine hermaphrodite, within 3 points on the path of evolution, the monads of love, working on the